Mark, for the second time in as many days, the Edmond School District is under fire.
Administrators are defending another school bus mix-up. This time, children were dropped off at the wrong location and found wandering by themselves. Eyewitness News5's Carla Wade is live in the newsroom. And Carla, you talked to their mom.
That's right, Paul. I talked to those two little boys' mother, and she says that she's really lost trust in the district. The Edmond School's transportation director, though, says it was a simple misunderstanding that should have never happened.
We have been taking them to school. They'll never ride the bus again. Never. After this, what's going to happen next? Maybe they'll end up on the other side of town.
Michelle Campbell's two sons, 7 and 9 years old, were not that far from home, but they didn't know that. Kimberly Benaya saw the boys just after they were dropped off here at these apartments.
They looked quite frightened and they were walking in the wrong direction.
Campbell says the boys told the volunteer bus monitor, who's also a teacher at Orvis Reisner Elementary School, that it wasn't their stop.
Edmond Public Schools refuses to take any responsibility, refuses to take any disciplinary action for this teacher.
But Edmond Public Schools Transportation Director Kenny Chamley says the volunteer thought the boys lived somewhere in the complex, but were not outside their building. For kids who live here, the bus only stops near the front of the complex.
And she stated, well, you'll have to get off and walk.
Chamley says the volunteer should have talked to the driver, who could have figured out where the boys belonged.
If this had been brought to our driver, that he would have known exactly what to do.
I'm sorry, if she can't be a bus monitor, do you want her teaching your kids? I don't.
Campbell is grateful to the woman who saw her two lost boys, called her, and then kept them safe until she could pick them up.
She called me and she's like, I can't pay you any money for helping me. And I was like, all I wanted was them for to be home.
Now, Chamley says if the driver had been notified, he could have called back to the base and then he could have determined exactly where those boys should have been dropped off. Carla Wade, Eyewitness News 5.
Okay, Carla, the district transports 8,000 to 10,000 students a day. They say even just one mistake is not acceptable.